Saturday. Small Business Saturday. And it's almost 10 o'clock a.m. And I just woke up. Oops. So, this vlog I decided to do a exercise vlog because I do so much stuff, so much different stuff for exercise. Honestly, because I think it's fun, and some of it is because of my profession, my dreams and my goals require my body to be in good shape. But I mean, there's a whole bunch of reasons. But I just do a lot, and there's still more I want to do. But I just want to kind of give a vlog because every day I do different things, and every day I don't work out, but it's kind of like, you know, I integrated so many kinds of exercise. I have so many options. I kind of wanted to show, like, you can incorporate exercise into your life however you want to. So I'm just showing, like, you know, different days, different exercises. You feel me? And maybe some stuff that I do, maybe you haven't thought of before, you haven't tried before, or different combinations. So right now I'm on my way to hot yoga, my newest thing that I've been into, and part of how I got into it, you know, because I always heard of hot yoga and always thought, like, that's really extreme, like you're gonna sweat so much, like put your body through so much heat, and then try to like meditate and be active, like, you know, do yoga within it. And I just thought it was a really extreme form of exercise for people who are just extreme, you know. And I was just like, nah, you know, because I'm into macrobiotics, I'm not really into extremes, you know, I'm trying to avoid that. But, you know, I have this issue with my back. You know, I do the best that I can with what information I know that I'm able to control with my back spasms. And honestly, I mean, I love my chiropractor. She has helped me with so much. She's helped me. I mean, there's no way I could be where I am today without her help, you know, with my back. And she's a kind and supportive person. No matter what profession she would be in, she would be, you know, a great whatever, because she's just very kind and supportive. And, you know, she helps when I thought, like, oh, this is it, I can't dance anymore. No, she was helping me through that mental drama. But anyways, I'm just trying to find a different way. And I thought, you know, my back went into a little bit of a spasm last week, and I know exactly why. And I was just like, I really don't want to go to the chiropractor again. And it's honestly because it is expensive. It's like, even though, you know, my chiropractor does, you know, work with me because I don't have insurance, you know, and she understands, you know, I don't make a lot of money. She does work with me, but at the same time, it's like, oh my God, I'm just trying to find a different way. So I thought, maybe the hot yoga, because at my work, we have the sauna, the infrared sauna. And then I was just thinking, I was like, well, if I love the infrared sauna, just sitting in there, and then I love doing yoga because just regular yoga helps my back. That's the only exercise I did for like 6 months when my hips were crooked and I couldn't dance. So I was like, hey, well, why not try hot yoga? So there's a studio in my area that offered 7 days unlimited classes for only $20. And regularly, one class would be $20. So it's like, hey, great. So that's what I've been doing. This is, I guess, I did it Wednesday, Thursday. I didn't do it Friday. Yeah, so this is day four. So I'm really excited to do it. I mean, it is really... And plus, when I did my Vedic astrology, my lady who did my reading said, because my physical body is ruled by the moon, that's the planet that rules my physical body, she said, you know, my tendency, even as I touch my hands are cold, my tendency is for when I'm out of balance that my body gets cold. So she said, to help stay in balance, do warming stuff, like stuff that'll keep you warm, like, you know, long distance running. Sorry about it. Walking, which I love to walk. I love to take long walks. She said, hot yoga, you know, get into the sauna. She said, dancing, which is fine. I dance all the time. So that's cool. So, you know, I am pretty flexible, but like I said, I do have problems with my back. So there are certain postures that are like so... Like, because we don't hold the poses for such a long time, but, you know, we do hold them for a little bit, and there's certain postures. I think it's called the camel, where you bend backwards, like you're on your knees and you have your hands here and you bend back. That one is the worst posture for me. It's like I haven't been able to hold it. Even in regular yoga class, it's such an uncomfortable pose for me. But maybe today it might be better. I don't know. But I think it's because, you know, I have issues with my back. It's like that posture is so like, ugh. But I don't know. I like it. It's fun. I don't know. I've been really into it. The only thing is afterwards when you're so sweaty and your yoga mat's all sweaty and your towel's all sweaty and your clothes are all sweaty and then you're in your car. I think my car is starting to smell bad because of it. So that's the only thing. I have to figure out a way how to deal with that, but I really like it. I don't know. I think it's fun. I don't know. I think it's fun. So that's what I'm doing today. That's my exercise of today, is the hot yoga. Plus, I would just want to say, it has been helping my back. I mean, you know, it's less, the degree that it helps is less than my chiropractor, but I'm testing it out. I'm seeing like, okay, how many classes will it take for my back to come back into alignment, you know? Because it has helped. I mean, it's every class, my back feels a little bit better. My hips are not as crooked, you know? I'm not in as much pain. So that's where we are today. And I'll see you guys soon. Peace. So this day, I almost did an exercise.
I was so exhausted, but at the last minute, I was like, you know what? I haven't exercised today, and I haven't taken a walk in a very long time. Just a little walk around the neighborhood, not a big deal. So I really like to take a walk. I love looking at the plants, listening to the sounds of nature. There's some really cute houses in my neighborhood. I'm showing you guys some of my favorite plants and some of my favorite scenes from my neighborhood. And I really love to look at the mountains in the distance. And the way the sunlight looked. And this is actually my favorite tree. Really love this tree, and I hope one day I can communicate with it. That's one of my goals in my life, is to talk to plants and animals.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live.
Another day, another new exercise. My eyes look really dark because makeup residue, or I don't really know. But anyways, today I'm going to hot yoga again. It's the last day of my 7 days for $20. So, yeah, yesterday I didn't go, or I didn't do any kind of exercise yesterday because I had to work in the morning, and then I had a meeting, and then I had to teach in the afternoon, evening. It was like that, and I was so exhausted. Part of the problem is me going to bed late. That's the biggest problem. But also just, I don't know. I think I'm just, becoming more sensitive and, more clairsentient. I know my eating is still weird. And it's partly because of my time restriction that I have on a lot of things, and also because I'm just tired. But you gotta still do your best. So that's why I'm going to hot yoga today. I wanted to show you guys my outfit that I wear in the hot yoga studio. So, as I mentioned, you sweat a lot in there. So people usually wear like sports bras, shorts, or even like swimsuits, like leotards or bikini tops, or because it's just so sweaty in there. I'm gonna show you as best as I can. So this sports bra I got from Poshmark, brand new with tags. It's from the company Aloe, which that is a company that I'm obsessed with right now. I bought one of their leggings on a bundle on Poshmark one time, just because like I wanted to get some Lululemon leggings from this one seller, and I saw she had these cute Aloe ones, and I was like, oh, I never tried Aloe, but they're cute, maybe, you know. And so I bought them, and they were so much more comfortable than Lululemon, the fabric. It had like a more relaxed stretch. It wasn't relaxed fit, but like when it stretched, it wasn't so like as Lululemon. It was like more relaxed. I don't know how to describe it. Maybe it was just that style. But I really liked it, so I was like, ooh, let me check out Aloe. And so I'm like checking their new arrivals every day on Poshmark, and I really think their styles are so cute. They are kind of expensive too, so it's great to check out Poshmark to get some Aloe stuff. So this one was called the Ripped Warrior, because it has like ripped stuff. And I wanted to get some sports bras like this that are like longer, that could be like a crop top, like if you had high-waisted leggings. So I like this back part, it's really cute. And then these shorts I got like a year ago or something. These ones are from Lululemon. Also, I got them from Poshmark. These were not new with tags, I don't remember, but they're just, they're shorter. I forgot what they're called. Shorty shorts or hottie shorts, something like that. But they scrunch right here and you can tie them. And I thought they were really cute. I originally got them when I was doing what was it? My circus workout stuff, because at my circus studio they also did pole classes, and I thought I was gonna get into pole dancing, which I only took one class. So what does that tell you? Did I get into it? No. But never say never, I might go back to it. But yeah, they're just really short, and they're good for, you know, hot yoga or pole dancing, so. And also too, I wear them underneath my dresses and my skirts when I go swing dancing. So multiple. Oh, and one time I did wear them for a dance class, but I had a leotard, and so it was like that. So, but anyways, yeah, I'm gonna go to hot yoga now, and I'll see you guys tomorrow, hopefully for the next workout. All right, friends. So, today is Thursday. It's about 11:45. My exercise yesterday for Wednesday, I didn't get to do any kind of exercise because I was working at my other job 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and then at 7 p.m. to 9:30-ish, I had my crystal healing class. So there was really no time to exercise. But today, however, originally I had 3 different classes planned, which would have been my exercise, but so just now I had my ballet class, that's why I had this bun, and you would have thought I was doing hot yoga because of how sweaty I got. No, just ballet class for an hour. I think, people, my back is better. I think the hot yoga is key to integrate into my life, because otherwise I would have had to go to the chiropractor at least once. But this way, doing the hot yoga, not only does it help my back, you know, it's a great way to meditate. It's, you know, you're sweating, releasing so many toxins, improving your blood circulation, your breathing. It's you know, doing those poses and stuff. It's stretching, it's strengthening, which is all things that are beneficial for ballet. And today my ballet teacher told me my balance is getting better, which I already knew, because I felt it in my body. Like, I could tell, like, I can balance on one leg for the appropriate amount of counts in the exercise. So it's really cool. It's hot yoga, I think, is the key, man. And the last time I went to hot yoga, I had a different teacher, and she told me that usually they have a teacher there who's also a professional ballet dancer, but he's on tour right now. And she's like, yeah, when he comes back from his tour, you know, it'd be great for you to learn from him, because, you know, he's in your place too. He knows about ballet and everything that's important for your body in that way. And he also, you know, knows hot yoga. So it's like, ah, cool, so happy. Yeah, I'm really excited about that. And then later today, I'm so thankful I have some time, a few hours before I have to go work my other job. I don't think I really even told you guys what my other job is. It's basically, I work at a wellness center, like a natural kind of wellness center. So we have all kinds of healing modalities, whatever you're into. We have massage, cupping, saunas, no, we don't have acupuncture. We have Reiki, crystal healing, float pods, Himalayan salt rooms. We do so many workshops and events. Like, so many people in our area are, you know, like wellness kind of coaches or nutritionists or just so many different kinds of people who are into natural kind of living, natural kind of health and healing. We have so many workshops all the freaking time. Like, today we're gonna have a CBD workshop. We have like 2 or 3 CBD workshops a month, and we also sell so many, like a variety of CBD products. We also sell crystals, incense, sage. We also have an organic cafe, and we have so many, you know, vegan, vegetarian options. Still, we have meat and cheese and eggs and all that. And, you know, because there's so many different kinds of people out there, so many different kinds of people follow a different kind of diet, you know, and all that. I mean, in my perfect world, I would make our cafe, you know, macrobiotic, but macrobiotic can be different depending on who you are, you know? So maybe it's macrobiotic for some people to eat meat. Not the best, but maybe, you know, if they're coming from a lifestyle that was like a drug addict, alcoholic, you know, really in extreme kind of lifestyle, just cutting out that extreme substance is enough to call yourself macrobiotic. You feel me? It's a whole thing. But anyways, we also have yoga classes, and this is my point that I'm getting to. I'm gonna try Tai Chi for the first time because we offer Tai Chi at my work. And so before I clock in, I'm gonna do the Tai Chi class. And I'm really excited about it because I've been wanting to try Tai Chi for such a long time. That was like before I got into jiu-jitsu. I wanted to do Tai Chi, but like it's kind of hard to find a little bit. And it's also, it was hard for me to find a place where the time of the class fit my schedule. But now that my schedule is a little bit different, you know, and it's really right there at my work, girl. So I'm really excited about it. And then after, I was gonna go to my jiu-jitsu, I don't know what you call it, studio. They call it the gym, but I feel like it's not really a gym because it's just mats on the floor. But I don't know what you would call it. But I haven't been to jiu-jitsu in like 2 weeks. It's really bad. And it's so funny because I think this is how all 10th planet places are. You always take a picture after the class. So, and then we post it. We have a group, like a chat kind of thing for everybody that goes to my jiu-jitsu place. And every day for every class, the teachers or the coaches post the pictures of who was there at the class. And it's like, Michelle hasn't been there. girl, it's been like 2 weeks and we haven't seen your picture on here. It's just like, I know probably no one's thinking that. It's probably just in my head, but it's just cause like last week I had my back spasm. Plus it was Thanksgiving, so I really wanted to spend time, you know, with people that I loved. And not that I don't love my jiu-jitsu people. It's just like, you know, I see them more often than I see, you know, like my boyfriend or, you know, so. And then this week, my schedule is just like, every day is different. So it's kind of cool because then every day is different. So then I can do different stuff every day. You feel me? So it's kind of cool in that way. But then it's kind of like, sometimes I can't make it to class for 2 weeks. But anyways, so I was gonna try, we have a new class at my jiu-jitsu place called Mai Tai. I think it's called Mai Tai. And it's kind of like, I don't really know what it is, but from what the videos that I've been seeing people post, it's like kind of like punching and kicking. So it's not like jiu-jitsu where it's like more kind of like wrestling. But, and then the kicking part, I was like, girl, I'm gonna slay everybody with my kicks, girl. Like, come on, seriously? So I wanted to try it, but just because I forgot that today we had an event at my work, I know I'm gonna have to stay there longer. So probably I can't. It's another week. Actually, maybe tomorrow I can go to jiu-jitsu. And it was also contingent on my back being okay. And my back's okay. And I feel like Tai Chi would probably help too my back.
And then maybe tomorrow I can go to morning jujitsu class. And then I have, then I can finally go to ballet class at my other studio for like 4 hours. And then I have rehearsal. So it's just a cool thing. So anyways, yeah, so today, ballet class, Tai Chi. That's my exercise of the day. So it's cool because it's like I get more exercise today just because that's how it worked out. But, you know, some other days I didn't have time to do it. So it's kind of like, you know, you find a different balance. So that's it.
All right, people. So this morning I went to jujitsu class. It was pretty good. It was all right. I'm glad I was finally able to make it to class after all this time. My back wasn't bothering me and, well, too much. But I just thought I'd show you what I ate. Some leftover udon noodles with carrots and onions. My recipe for bomb tofu. And sweet potatoes. And it was really amazing. And it fueled me for it. I had a long day of ballet, progressive ball technique, and nutcracker rehearsal, and I was almost going to improv dance again, but I was way too tired, barely had enough energy to do this voiceover, but that's all the exercise I did this week. Hope you got some inspiration. See you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Peace, and also, think differently.